is my joint to stand me up like this. Not even a phone call or anything.
Oh, Howard, I'm scared. Maybe we should call the police.
Oh, Marion, you're getting upset over nothing.
Nothing? Tickets to a Chubby Checker concert at $2 each? You call that nothing? Huh? And this tie. Tie cost me $1. You'll call that nothing? Huh? And what about this belt, Mr. C, huh? 75 cents. Is that nothing, too?
You know, you're worried about all the money you spent, and Joni could have been in an accident.
Oh, my
God. No, no, Marion, she wasn't in an accident. I was just trying to make a point.
Yeah, and I got a haircut. It cost me another $1.
Yeah. You got robbed.
I know.
In there. Well, Cunningham, is this your daughter?
Oh, come on, Kirk. You know that's my daughter. Now, what's going on?
Not so fast, Cunningham. Is this your daughter?
Yes, 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 yes. That's my daughter. All right, now what happened?
She was trying to steal General Pfister's statue.
Oh, oh, come on. Oh, that's the most...
Hold it there, Romeo. Back it up in formation there. Best if you take it easy. I'm in charge here. Now, Cunningham, since your daughter's a minor, I'm going to leave her in your custody. But you'll have to appear in court. You'll be properly notified. And as for the young lady who tried to talk her out of it, I'd be proud to give you a personal escort home, little lady.
Well, Johnny, I'm really sorry. I don't know what to do.
Take it off! Just... Move it out!
Sorry.
Joni, I can't believe it happened the way he said it did. Now, something is rotten here.
Mm, and I know who it is.
Oh, no, let's not overreact. We'll have to move away. We'll make a fresh start.
Marion! Now, come on, it couldn't have happened the way Kirk said. Our daughter is not a vandal. I'm right, aren't I, sweetheart?
No, I'm a vandal. I did it.
Oh, sweetheart, now if you wanted a statue, why didn't you tell us? We would have bought you one.
Are you trying to tell me that you went to a park to steal a statue? When you had the chance to go with me to see Chubby Checker in concert, huh? I don't buy that for a second.
It's true.
And Jenny went there to talk you out of it?
Yeah.
All right, Joni. I want you to look me straight in the eye and say that you're telling the truth.
I'm telling you the truth.
You're looking at my chin. Look me in the eye.
Jenny wanted the statue, and I went to the park to talk her out of it.
Now, Joni, if Jenny wanted to steal the statue and you tried to talk her out of it, why did you take all the blame?
Yeah.
Well, it's hard to explain. See, it's something about protecting her father. I don't know. She talks faster than I can listen.
Well, I know one thing. That Jenny Piccolo has been nothing but trouble ever since you met her when you were 6 years old. And I'm going to get her parents on the phone, tell them to get over here tomorrow night, and we're going to straighten this out.
No, Dad, you can't call her father. He's a very fragile man. News like this could kill him.
I'm sorry, Joni. I don't want to kill the man, and I'll be as gentle as I can. But I'm not going to stand by and let you take the blame for something you didn't do. I should have done this years ago. Tomorrow night, the Cunninghams and the Piccolos are going to have it out.